Tony was my best friend, and he was a truly remarkable man. He was an amazing plant expert. He knew, he had gotten a university degree in botany and a degree in landscaping, and if you showed him a plant, he would tell you the name in Latin. The grounds around his house were a magnificent showpiece, beautiful. He had many talents, and one rather surprising one was archery. he competed and became the Grand National Champion of Great Britain. He would have represented them in the Olympics, except for an injury, which kept him from that. he was outstanding at other projects. He took on the project of building an addition on their house, and he went and bought a book and did the entire thing himself. He, from the foundation to the walls and the floors and the roof. Absolutely unexpected. He had many other interests. One was yachting. He had acquired a yacht in Kinsale, would sleep two people, and sailed it to home along the coast. He took up winemaking and made all the wine that he and Betty had with their evening meals. he had a warm personality and a keen sense of humor. And we would, on Wednesday nights, go to Nolan's and watch snooker on the television and share opinions and thoughts, and I will miss him. I loved him. Betty has asked me to express her gratitude and thanks to the Fairfield Nursing Home in Drimalig, the Haven Bay Home House in Kinsale, especially the weekend charge nurse, Jan, who was, for her extreme kindness, and for their help and support, Dr. Martin, Dr. Wilson, and Dr. Mullins, and for his helpful care and professionalism to Mike Daly.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, Forgive us our sins and lead us to everlasting life. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. O God, glory of the faithful and life of the just, we have been with thee. Look merciful on your departed servant for thee, that just as he professed the mystery of our resurrection, so he may merit to receive the joys of eternal happiness. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Take the seat of now, and we listen to the word of God. That we must know the Father.
The souls of the virtuous are in the hands of God. No torment shall ever touch them. In the eyes of the unwise, they did appear to die. Their going looked like a disaster. Their leaving us like annihilation. But they are in peace. If they experience punishment as men see it, their hope was rich with immortality. Slight was their affliction. Great will be their blessing. God has put them to the test and proved them worthy to be with him. He has tested them like gold in a furnace and accepted them as a holocaust. They who trust in him will understand the truth. Those who are faithful will live with him in love, for grace and mercy await those he has chosen. This is the word of the Lord.
A reading from the first letter of St. John. We shall see him as he really is. Think of the love that the Father has lavished on us by letting us be called God's children, and that is what we are. Because the world refused to acknowledge him, and therefore it does not acknowledge us. My dear people, we are already the children of God, but what we are to be in the future has not yet been revealed. All we know is that when it is revealed, we shall be like him, because we shall see him as he really is. This is the word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Seeing the crowds, Jesus went up the hill. There he sat down and was joined by his disciples. Then he began to speak. This is what he taught them. How happy are the poor in spirit. Theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Happy the gentle. They shall have the earth for their heritage. Happy those who mourn. They shall be comforted. Happy those who hunger and thirst for what is right. They shall be satisfied. Happy the merciful. They shall have mercy shown them. Happy the pure in heart. They shall see God. Happy the peacemakers. They shall be called sons of God. Happy those who are persecuted in the cause of right. Theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Happy are you when people abuse you and persecute you and speak all kinds of calumny against you on my account. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward will be great in heaven. This is the gospel of the Lord. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward will be great in heaven. My dear friends, there are many mysteries in life. The mysteries of wars, the mysteries of pandemics, the mysteries of sicknesses. But the greatest of all mystery is the mystery of death. Why death? Why all these mysteries? And no matter how well we address all these issues, we will never come up with the complete answer, particularly with debt. Why debt? Yet it confronts us at all times. And today we are confronted by the debt of Tony. And no matter how well we are prepared for debt, no matter how strong our faith is, when death comes, there is a sting. There is a shadow of loneliness. Human touch, human feelings, human emotions. But for those who believe in a resurrection, death is not the end. It's changed. We are saying farewell to Tony today. And if we say that this is the end of Tony Garrod, we are making a mistake. Because for Tony, and our belief is that Tony's life has changed dramatically. We are saying farewell to him in our loneliness. But by the fact that we believe in a resurrection, and that resurrection took place on the first Easter morning. And for many, it found it very difficult to come to terms with the resurrection. The friends of the Lord, the apostles, found it extremely difficult to accept that he had risen from the dead. He had overcome death. And for generations of people, it is the same. They find it very difficult that somebody overcame death. And this is our belief. Not alone the belief that he overcame death, but the Lord prepared us for the way. On that famous Holy Thursday evening where he instituted the Eucharist, and he says, this is the bread, this is the living bread that he gives us. And that gives us a great nourishment. It gives us great hope. And we reflect on Tony's life today. Orrin gave him a beautiful tribute about his landscaping gardening, his skills in the garden, his skills in sport. A person that should have gone to the Olympics. For one reason or another, he didn't make it. But that didn't matter. He was a wonderful achiever of life. And the testimony he has left behind is that lovely garden in Borgesia, where that lovely home he had created for almost 27 years. He developed this home in Borgesia, and his garden. And when he was developing his garden, particularly the soil, he was putting his hands on the soil, and he was close to nature, close to his God. He knew the experience of the harshness of winter, the new spring of life, the full bloom of summer, and then the autumn, where plants relaxed and went back to the dead again. But there was the time that the Tony was totally close to the Lord, and he must have been close through the plants that he developed, the skills that he developed in planting them, in naming them, and in nourishing them. And this today, of all days, a lovely crisp morning, that Tony would love to be out in his garden. Today, he's in the garden full of rejoicing. We struggle with Tony's death. Yes, we struggle with her fate. But if we develop our faith and nourishment with the Lord, preparing for us on our journey, life is one short journey that we all are making. We pray that we support and care for each other. We support and care for each other in the community. We support and care with each other for life. Yes, Christmas time is coming by, and this is going to be a difficult time more than any other time. But all we can is to put trust and confidence in the living God that has come down from heaven, that has united us with the homeland in heaven. We pray that we develop our faith and trust in the Lord, just as Tony did in this life. We ask the Lord to welcome him in his homeland. May the angels welcome you, Tony, into your homeland. May you be at peace. May you rest in peace. We'll stand now for the prayers of the faithful. God, the Almighty Father, he has raised his Son, Jesus Christ, from the dead. With confidence, we ask him to save his people, living and dead. For Tony, who has fallen asleep in the hope of rising again, that he may see God face to face, Lord, hear us. For our relatives and friends who have gone before us and await the kingdom, that they may have their reward of their goodness, Lord, hear us. For those whose fate was known to you alone, that they may have the light and the happiness and the peace, Lord, hear us. For all who mourn for the loss of Tony, that they will find comfort in their sadness, certainty in their doubt, courage in their loneliness, Lord, hear us. And for ourselves who are assembled here to worship in faith, that we may be reunited one day with Tony, when every tear will be wiped away, Lord, hear us. God, our shelter and our strength, you listen in love to the cry of your people. Hear the prayers we offer for Tony. Cleanse him of his sins and grant him the fullness of redemption through Christ our Lord. Please be seated now.
Thank you. Let us pray now that our sacrifice of the bread and wine may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Lord, cease the hands of the praise and glorious name for our benefit of all the church. As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Tony, we beseech your mercy that he who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Saviour may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him, the hope of the blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim, Holy, Holy, Holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Let us now proclaim the mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered in by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring it to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Fenton our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant Tony, whom you've called today from this world to yourself. Grant that he, who was united with your Son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen. At the Saviour's command and formed by divine teaching, we now say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we wait the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. We now look into our own hearts to search for peace, peace within ourselves, peace within our families, peace within our community, but most of all, peace within our world. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Lord Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, by whom the will of the Father and the work of the Holy Spirit, through your death, give us life into the world, free us of this most holy body and from all sins and from every evil. Keep me always faithful to your commandments. Never let me depart from you. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body of Christ keep me safe for eternal life. May the blood of Christ keep me safe for eternal life.
Thank you.
Lord God, whose days are without end and whose mercies beyond counting, keep us mindful that life is short and the hour of death is unknown. Let your Spirit guide our days on earth in the ways of holiness and justice, that we may serve you in union with the whole Church, sure in faith, strong in hope, perfect in love. And when our earthly journey is ended, lead us rejoicing into your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Saints of God, come to his aid, hasten to meet you, angels of the Lord. May Christ who called you take you to himself, may angels lead you to the bosom of Abraham. Eternal rest at the throne, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine. Together with all who have died in Christ, you will rise again. Merciful.